Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. So as you can see, it's actually dark outside. It's literally like 7 o'clock in the morning right now and it doesn't get bright here until about 9 o'clock. So I'm up early this morning doing a couple of bits and I really couldn't wait to record this and fill you in on what has been happening for the last couple of months that I've been keeping a massive secret. So I can't wait to fill you in now and tell you from start to finish. So I actually already announced this on Instagram, but if you haven't seen it, I'm actually releasing my own fitness app in the new year. And that's what I've been working on for the last couple of months. It's been a big massive secret that I couldn't really tell you about until I had the finer details in order. There has been so much work put into this app and I'm just so happy that I can finally tell you about it and bring you along the little journey with me. So as many of you would already know, I do have guides out at the moment. So I have my 8-week workout plan for beginners and more advanced gym goers, and I also have a nutrition ebook. But I kind of felt over the last few months that there's only so much that you can do with workout and nutrition guides, as opposed to having a platform where you can update it regularly the more you learn and just actually have more of a community rather than just a PDF, if you get me. So obviously I really believe in my ebooks and they did really well and I had a lot of good feedback about them over the last couple of months, but I really did think having something like an app where we can all communicate together, where I can constantly update the workouts and meal plan templates and meal ideas and also upload articles and informative videos as well, is just something that would offer a lot more value to ye. And it would obviously just keep me busier as well and keep me doing the things I love every single week. So those are a couple of the features. As I mentioned there, I'm gonna have workouts from home and from the gym for beginner, intermediate and advanced gym goers. So they're all separate 12-week programs. So in total, when I do launch the app, there's gonna be up to about a year of workouts there just from the get-go, and I will be adding to those all the time. So another feature I'm going to have is a calorie and macronutrient calculator. So once you sign up to the app, I'm going to have a series of questions to ask you, and once you answer them and tell me your goals, I can basically tell you what your calories and macros are, and you can put those into your food diary and do the if it fits your macros approach, which is what I'm actually doing myself at the moment for my bulk, and I also do it while I'm cutting. And in the food diary, we're going to have a food bank, and we're also going to have like a barcode scanner feature. Most people do eat similar foods each week, so if you scan a food once and input it, then it's going to be there forever, and it'll basically just be really easy for you to track your calories and macros as you go on in your fitness journey. Another feature I will have will be meal plan templates. So these are there just to give you an idea of what a full day of eating can look like with your calories and macros. They're not really there to be copied, because I prefer to actually teach you how to choose your own foods. But these will just be here to help you to decide what kind of foods you want to eat and just get meal ideas as well. So I put together some meal ideas for breakfast, lunch, dinner, pre and post workout, and I'll be adding to those continuously as well. So there'll always be new ideas and new foods for you to try out. Of course, then we're going to have a profile section where you can document your progress, you can upload your before and after pictures, and basically check in with yourself each week with your weight, how you're feeling and different things like that, so you can track your own progress, even with charts and different diagrams to show you how you're doing. And then of course, as I mentioned, we're going to have informative videos and articles uploaded all the time as well, so that you're constantly learning and you can be in charge of your own progress going forward, because that's one thing I really preach on my channel and really live by, is actually educating you as opposed to just telling you what to do. I think it's so important to actually learn how to do things yourself, because these are life skills that you'll use basically forevermore in your fitness journey, and you can obviously help your own friends and family then as well. So that's all I can really tell you about the features so far. I can get into finer details as the weeks go on. It will be a monthly subscription based app as well, so it'll be free to download, but once you sign up then there will be a monthly fee, which I can also tell you about over the next few weeks. And just so you know as well, I did have a couple of companies get onto me over the last few months asking if I wanted to build an app with them where they would basically do all the work for me and I just say yes, no, and they get like a percentage of the company and things like that. But so there's actually only 3 people working behind this with me that I've handpicked myself. So I have my app developer, Morgan. I have my app designer, James, and I have Gary as well helping me with all the nutrition side of things too. So I haven't just gone to any team and told them, oh yeah, I want an app, but I want you to do all the work, because then I couldn't have it the way I wanted it to be. So I've done a lot of research and a lot of work over the last couple of months to find the people that really I could trust and know that they could give me exactly what I want and give you something valuable that you look forward to using every day. So I've definitely found that with the people I am working with. And yeah, I don't think there's much else I can say about it. I'm just really, really excited to finally tell you about it, to finally fill you in on what I've been doing for the last couple of months. And there are actually other things in store that I'll be chatting about in the next few weeks, but not really fitness related. This was my kind of big fitness move and I really have given it my all, so I hope you guys love it as much as I do. I'll have loads of more details out over the next couple of weeks, but that's just what I wanted to fill you in on this morning. It will be releasing in the new year, so I'm hoping for the 1st of January, but I'm not going to set that in stone yet until everything is finalized, because I would hate for people to, you know, be waiting for that and then, you know, if it's not up by the 1st. But look, I'm not setting in stone. I will over the next week or two, so just keep your eyes peeled over on my Instagram and here on YouTube as well. So yeah, it's a little bit different to the ebooks in that with ebooks you kind of do a lot of work for a couple of weeks and then release it and then that's just it until your next ebook. Whereas with this app, it's going to be like a constant influx of information every week. So it's going to be a lot more work for me and I will be a lot busier, but I am so excited for it. And as I said, the more I learn as I go on, the more I can teach you through this app as well, because I really did want it to be educational and so far it's really looking like it will be. So I hope you love it and I hope you learn from it and it's just going to be really fun. So other than that, as I said, it's very early in the morning and I have a good few things to do before I have my pre-workout meal and get through my day, but myself and Gary have a really fun day planned anyway, so I'm going to bring you through that with me and I'm going to go and get changed now and eat my pre-workout meal in a few minutes after I do some work, so stay tuned. Okay, so anyway, it's time for me to work out, so I've already had my Cheerios and I'm going to have a protein shake now too. So I'm using the Impact Whey Isolate as usual from my protein in chocolate smooth flavour, and this is a cute new shaker they have. They have these in a couple of different colours, so if you're looking to pick them up, then I'll leave the link in my description box. And to be honest, I'm feeling rather exhausted today, so I'm going to have some pre-workout too. And this one is sour gummy flavour, so I'm going to try this as well. Even though I normally wouldn't depend on pre-workout drinks, I'm going to need it today for the extra kick. I recorded all the clips for my app 2 days ago with Ben. He came down from Dublin and we were recording literally all day long. I'd say I did over 1,000 reps in total trying to get everything perfect for the clips, but my body is absolutely broken after it. But I took a rest day yesterday, so I'm going to go back to it today. So I think I'm going to train shoulders because my legs are just too sore. They're just killing me after. I think it was actually the cardio that killed me the most, the HIIT workouts rather than the actual weights, because I'm not used to doing that much cardio in one day. But yeah, that's my plan. And I think you're training back, Gary, is it?
Yeah, pull for me.
Okay, so Gary has pull and I have push. So we better get going and I'll catch you at the gym. Views this morning are lovely. Yeah, it was a grim start to the day with the weather, but it's really hard to pick it up now.
Was it raining
this morning? Oh, it was so dark and rainy.
I didn't even know that.
I hate that in the mornings when it's really, really dark and it feels like night time already, but it's hard to pick it up now.
Like, that's the only thing that I don't like for the winter is that, like, it's the day actually feels like it's like 4 or 5 hours because of the darkness just kicks in at like 4 p.m, 5 p.m, and then it's like day is over.
Yeah, it's so bad. I feel like I just opened the curtains in the living room and then I'm closing them like 3 hours in. Okay, we just arrived at the gym and I'm not sure if I showed you the new gym I'm training at yet. So this is it from the outside. I'm in the car now, so I can't really get the symbol in, but it's called Motivated Fitness and they're in Grange. So they're like, for anyone living in Cork, they're like by Musgraves, and I'm so happy I moved here. The previous gym I was at was just so overpopulated all the time, I couldn't even train properly there, so I knew I needed a change, and this gym opened just in time and it's like 5 minutes down the road from me when there's no traffic, obviously. So yeah, it's perfect here and it has like probably the best machinery in Cork, to be fair, for
it has world class equipment, honestly.
Yeah, the equipment is really, really good. So that's where all my recent workout clips have been at. Crashing, hit a wall. Right now, I need a miracle. Hurry up now, I need a miracle. Stranded, reaching out. Need you right.
need you the most. So don't let me, don't let me, don't let me down.
Workout done, and we're going to do some cardio because why the hell not? We're going to go on the bikes today. I actually haven't used a spinning bike honestly in about 3 years, I'd say. I normally just go on the cross trainer or the treadmill, but yeah, Gary insists on the spinning bike, so we're going to have a bash off those now for a few minutes, have some fun with it, and then get on with our day. Okay, guys, that is our workout done, and we're both kind of sweaty, not too sweaty. We didn't push ourselves too hard with cardio, but look, we got the heart rate up. And it's Sunday, so we're both going to be visiting our families today because we've honestly not been as great this week.
Slacking.
Yeah, we're slacking a little bit, and Mum and Dad are ringing us and stuff. So we're going over to Gary's house now and spend a bit of time there. Then we're going to get a food shop and go to my house, and we've some nice plans for tonight that I'm going to bring you through as well. So
sounds like a plan. Yeah. Let's do it.
Let's go. Okay, guys, we picked up our post-workout meal in the shop. So I got the natural confectionery jellies, but I got sour squirms today, as opposed to my usual dino mix or jungle mix. So, or jungle jellies, they call it, I can't remember. But yeah, I'm gonna have these today with my protein shake that I'm gonna put together now. And yeah, I just need to have a shower and get ready for the rest of the night. I'm actually really happy that the weather picked up because, as I said, myself and Gary are gonna go into town and we're gonna go for dinner firstly because it's our date night, it's Sunday. We had it today instead of yesterday because I was just really busy yesterday, so we're having our date night tonight. But yeah, so far so good today. That workout was really fun and the cardio was well needed as well. I feel really good after it because sometimes I'm just half allergic going into cardio, and then once I have it done I feel like 10,000 times better. So I'm happy I did it, and I'm just going to go in and have a shower now and start getting ready for this evening because I'm a sweaty mess. Okay, guys, I'm ready, and that honestly didn't take me as long as I thought it would, but it is pitch black outside already. But I'm just going to show you what I have on because it's something I wouldn't normally wear. So I picked up this big fluffy jumper from Pretty Little Thing during the week, and I'm only trying it on now, so I'm guessing you could wear it off both shoulders if you wanted, but I think I'm going to put it off like one shoulder. Yeah, my tan is a bit dodgy as well at the moment. I find when I put on tan and then wear like tight straps in my gym bras, I often get like marks along here. I don't think you can see it in this light, maybe like a little bit there. But look, I'll get away with it for dinner anyway, and I just tucked it into the jeans as well. But yeah, it's cozy and casual anyway, and I like it. It's really fluffy and soft. So as I said, tonight is date night for me and Gary, so we're going to be eating out. I feel like every time I'm doing like a vlog, I'm always going on a date night with Gary and I'm always eating off plan. So it's usually the weekends, guys, and I always vlog at the weekend. So I don't eat out every single night of the week, in case you are wondering, but I do every weekend with Gary or else with my friends. And especially this time of the year, I really don't see the point in restricting myself too much if I have nothing to prep for. And it's just a time of the year where you should be spending time with your friends and family, and you should not be restricting yourself unless obviously you have something important coming up, like a competition or a photo shoot prep that you've planned for yourself. But that's one thing I used to never really do before, even up to like last year and the couple of years before that when I was training and dieting. I would really restrict myself, and then I'd find myself lashing out more. So if you can do it gradually, even once a week, and enjoy yourself and learn how to leave your hair down but also get back on track the next day, then it's a really, really important skill. And it is a skill, it does take time, especially when you're tracking macros, because it can become quite obsessive at times. I've definitely seen it in myself and in other people, but once you get the hang of it and once you know how to come off plan but then also fall back in, then it's just really, really important for your progress long term. So don't be skipping your date nights and your time with your friends and family over Christmas, because honestly, life is too short and tracking macros will only bring you so far. What are you wearing, Gar?
So I have, what's this called?
It's like a knit jumper.
Yeah, so I have like a knit kind of cardigan jumper. I have a denim jacket, black jeans and gold.
Balenciaga. Yeah. I actually am going to have to ask, if I'm honest, right, I just really don't like these shoes. They're Balenciaga sock boots. I think they're just a really ugly shoe, but Gary loves them and he wears them all the time, and that's fine by me, like. But what are your thoughts on the Balenciaga sock boots?
I think they're pretty sick, to be honest. Nice and neat, very comfortable.
Oh, he's really talking him up here. Okay, Gary is hangry, so we better get going. I'll catch you in town. Okay, we're in town and it's absolutely freezing. But it's very Christmassy and cute, isn't it, Gary?
Yeah, it's weird.
I really do wish I could get Gary in the frame, but look, this is just an ongoing issue we have to live with. Okay, guys, we're at dinner now and we both just ordered our food, but Gary does this thing every time we go for dinner and I still don't understand it. So
every time we go out to eat, Gary takes off his watch because he says it makes you warm.
Yeah, it does, honestly.
How could this tiny piece of metal on your wrist make you warm?
It just does. It's just the way it is.
It's just the way it is. So it wouldn't be the big knit jumper you've on, no?
Nope. Just watch.
Okay, dinner is served. So this is the steak, pepper sauce and chips. It looks really plain, but it's really, really nice. And I also got some garlic bread. And Gary, you got something really similar, didn't you?
Yep.
You got the same, but he got mushrooms and stuff and onions and his as well. So let's dig in. Boom. Good, Gary, wasn't it?
No. 10 out of 10.
Gary always gets my leftovers. That's why I get garlic bread, because I know he's gonna take the last few chips then for the steak. Done. And to be honest, it was more towards kids, more like kids orientated, but it's just a really Christmassy vibe, and I did see other couples in there too, so we're not the only big kids around. But yeah, we're gonna go on the Ferris wheel now, and Gary absolutely hates heights, but it's like a Christmas tradition that we go on the Ferris wheel every year, so we'll go over there now and scare the shit out of Gary. Ready?
No.
Okay, Gary made a lucky escape, because the line to this Ferris wheel is honestly so, so long. So we're going to come back in. You're not getting away with it that easy. We're going to come back in.
Didn't see me scared yet.
We'll come back in. But yeah, it's too long for now. So we're just going to look around the markets now instead. And maybe come in during the week for the Ferris wheel. Okay, guys, we're back and we had such a lovely little date night. It was a little different to what we normally do, because obviously we have more options now with the markets and just the Christmas vibe going on. There's loads more to do. So the markets were nice for a change tonight after dinner, and it's a pity we couldn't go on the Ferris wheel, because honestly, Gary's reaction to heights is like the funniest thing in the world. So I know we couldn't do it tonight because the line was too long, but when we get around to that, I'm 100% going to bring my camera and record that footage, because you'll actually just think it's so funny that he's so tall and big but just still so afraid of heights at the same time. But anyway, it's actually quite late now and we've had a long old day, so I think I'm going to call it a day here with this video. But I hope you enjoyed it, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time.